Chapter 13. I could hear the TV from downstairs. I knew it wasn't that loud. My father always tried to keep it low after I'd gone to bed, but sounds always seemed to travel farther at night. If I lay perfectly still and strained my ears, I could make out some of what was being said, especially the commercials. They were always louder. I didn't know what time it was, but I did know it was late, at least 11:30, maybe later. I'd been in bed, or at least in my bedroom, since just before 10 o'clock. I couldn't sleep, so what else was new? I'd spent some time doing what I always did when I couldn't get to sleep. I'd watched my animals and played with them. Most of them, especially the rodents like the mice and hamsters and gerbils, were more active at night anyway. Others, like the squirrels, just wanted to sleep. I'd taken down the back of their nesting box and seen them all curled up together in one black ball, the heads and bodies and feet and tails of six squirrels all wrapped around each other so I couldn't see where one of them started or stopped. They looked peaceful together. It would have been nice to sleep that way. Sleep. I wasn't even feeling close to being able to sleep. I rolled out of my bed and moved across the floor toward the door. I inched out into the hall and stopped at the top of the stairs. The door to my sister's room was closed. There was no light visible under the door, and I was sure she was asleep. Sleep was practically all she ever did at home these days. Ever since she'd gotten that job downtown, she was always out, working or traveling to work or spending time with her friends or boyfriend. It was like she hardly lived here anymore. I could hear the TV a lot more clearly here. It was The Tonight Show with Jay Leno. I liked Leno. He seemed like a regular guy, like he could live up the street, the sort of neighbor who would help somebody out if they needed something. I could make out a few words, but not enough to understand what he was saying. Carefully, I crept down the stairs, avoiding the 11th and the 8th steps, which always creaked. I reached the bottom and sat on the very first step. From there, by craning my neck, I could see the television and my father. He was sitting in his chair, a laundry basket at his feet, folding clothes. Beside him, on the coffee table, sat a teapot in a cozy, a cup and a piece of toast. He laughed at one of Jay's jokes, but I didn't get it. My father poured himself a cup of tea and steam rose into the air. He took a sip and went back to folding the laundry. It was late, but it didn't surprise me to see my father still working. He always seemed to be working. My sister and I helped. We did more work around the house than any other kids I knew, but there was always so much to be done. Cooking, dishes, cleaning, buying groceries, laundry, yard work, paying bills, and those were just the things he had to do after working all day in a warehouse on the other side of the city. "Wouldn't you be more comfortable here on the couch?" my father called out. I smiled. So much for being sneaky. I stood up and joined him in the living room. "Do you want some tea?" he asked. "That would be nice." I walked into the kitchen and took a mug from the counter where they were drying. I grabbed the sugar bowl and brought it back with me. My father liked his with just a little milk. I liked sugar. The more sugar, the better the tea. 4 heaping spoonfuls. "Are you sure you don't want some tea with that sugar?" my father asked. "I'm trying to cut back a little," I said as I poured in the milk. "Who are his guests tonight?" "Some singer I don't know and a comedian I haven't heard of either." It really didn't matter to me who was on the show. I hardly ever knew who they were. I just liked being here, on the couch, watching my father. Maybe he didn't stop working, even this late, but at least he slowed down a bit. "So, anything interesting happening at school?" "You know, the snake thing?" "Oh yeah, that's right. Anything else?" "I'm trying out for the basketball team." "You'll make it," he said. "You're a good player." "I'm okay," I said. I didn't think he'd ever even seen me play, but it wasn't his fault. Even when the games were after school, he couldn't get there on time from work. Besides, if he ever did get home early, he would have 100 things to do around the house. "Your marks holding up?" "They're good." "What about art?" It was the only B on my interim report card. The rest were either an A or an A+. "I'm trying to improve it," I said. "Trying isn't enough. You have to bring your mark up. No choice." "I'll do it." "To get a scholarship to a good university, you need top marks. I'm working in a warehouse so that you never have to. Understand?" "I understand." "Good. You want some of my toast?" he asked. "Thanks," I said as I reached out and took one of the pieces. It was cold and hard, but that didn't matter either. "Stretch out there on the couch," he said. "You can stay up until I finish the laundry, and then we'd both better get to bed. It's getting late." I took a bite from the toast and a sip from my tea, and then laid down on the couch. I knew I'd be asleep within a few minutes. I also knew my father would then carry me upstairs, and I'd wake up in my own bed in the morning. I closed my eyes and let The Tonight Show guest sing me to sleep.